Hi, I'm Shauna Lee, and today I have a Goodwill haul for you guys. And this is all going to be stuff from the online Goodwill auction website thing. And I'm pretty excited about this video because I have a lot of good stuff in here. I have some stuff that probably wasn't worth it, like worth getting, I guess. And I'm going to try to make this video somewhat fast because it's like really hot in here right now, and I'm wearing a hat because my hair looks like garbage. So today is just an off day. So let's just get into the haul portion of this video. So the first thing that I have is in this bubble mailer thing. And oh, this one was interesting. So this is just like a gray hat, and it kind of looks like the Coach logo. I don't know if it actually is Coach or not because there's like no label or anything in here saying like, hey, this is Coach. But I got it anyways, and this was something that I probably shouldn't have gotten because, I mean, I think it was like really cheap though, like it was a dollar or something. But it's like, what am I... like, I can't really be like, hey, this is Coach, because there's no, like, actual, like, thing. It's just a square that says nothing. So, we'll see. I might have to sell it for, like, really cheap. But it's a little bucket hat, which is, it's pretty cute anyways. So, we'll call that good. So, that was it from that one. I'm gonna do all the small ones first. So, we have this FedEx Express box thing. And this is a belt. So this is a fossil belt. And this is the belt. It's just like a standard brown leather belt. And it's genuine leather. And here's the fossil logo on it, and it feels really nice. Like, it's very like flexible and soft, so that's a really nice belt. It is size 34, so really nice. I can't wait to post that. Okay, and we have another FedEx Express box. This one is a bit bigger. This one is another belt. Okay, so this one is a brown leather belt. This one's like a thicker braided belt, which is really cool. It is genuine leather and made in Turkey, and the size is medium on it. I don't know if it's coming up. And that's what the little buckle thing looks like. It's a really nice belt. This one, if I remember right, the shipping was absolutely ridiculous on, so I'm gonna have to charge more for this in order to make my money back. But I think it's a really nice belt, and it doesn't look like the leather has any damage to it, which is nice. So the next thing we have is a box, and I'm just gonna pull stuff out of this box. The first thing is a Talbot's bag. So this is the bag. It's like a crochet type thing, and it's new with tags. Talbot's. The original price was $30 on it, and it looks like it has like a little bamboo type zipper thing. Zipper works, and it's in really good condition, so it's a brand new condition, and it has like the little Talbot's logo on the inside of it too. So it's a nice little small purse. Cute. And then I have this Coach bag. It's one of the ones that have the little turn thing, and then it opens up, and then you see the inside of the bag. I figured I would get something that's Coach just because I don't know how well it sells, and I want to try to sell it. It looks like there's like a small stain on the outside, but I'll just disclose that, and I'll probably sell it for a little less than what other comps are going for. But, yeah. I wanted to try out Coach. I know Coach is, like, a brand that used to be, like, worth more, and then it just got oversaturated and stuff, so I know it's not going to be, like, super expensive now. But we're going to try it out and see what happens. And this one, I think this is something where I was like, I kind of regretted buying it after I got it. But this is a Bill Blast Jeans vest type thing, and there's like embroidery on it, and I thought this would be a nice like vintage piece to try to sell, but it's just a denim vest. We'll see if my instincts were correct or not. I don't know. I went on a little spree. And then I also got this Chico's button-up shirt. It's super patterned and stuff. It is a size 1. Oh, and this was a size large. Okay, and that is it from that box. This one is another Coach thing. I'm not sure. I think this might be supposed to be like a phone case, but like phones nowadays are really, really large. So maybe a coin purse? I don't know. Because I think it was supposed to be a phone case, but obviously phones are a little bit bigger now. So, but it's Coach. So we'll see what happens with this guy too. And I have this mini box full of men's 100% silk ties, and I'll just kind of showcase them real quick. I figured this was like just a bundle type thing, and I was like, you know what, I'll try it. It was really cheap. It was less than 10 bucks for all of these. So this is Bew Brimmel Soho. I don't know, but that's the design on the tie. Okay, this one is not in as good of condition. This is Xylos George Machado. George Machado, something like that. So, this one is Saracano, designed by Illy. There's the design on the tie. This one is Peebles. There's the tie. This one is John White. This one is Jones, New York. This last one is Bill Robinson. Okay, so that is it for the ties. So we have a larger box. And this one has a Scala Western style hat in it. And it has like the tie thing. There's Scala on the inside of the brim. I don't know if that's popping up, but it's a cute like Western style hat, which I think it's really nice. Tis cute as my pile grows. And then I also have this Made in Mexico embossed belt. I think that's right, embossed, whatever. It's a belt that's really nice, made in Mexico. This is the buckle on it, and then there's all that awesomeness on the belt, and it's Hecha en Mexico, basically Spanish for made in Mexico, and it's really nice. I'm pretty sure this one's 100%. I guess it doesn't say whether it's 100% leather, but it's really nice. It's size 34. Okay, and then we have a bag of belt buckles. So this was just a lot of belt a lot of belt buckles. It was a lot of belt buckles, and I thought this one I bought last minute because I decided at the last minute that I thought it was really cool. But this one is a Texas Sterling Collection 24 karat gold plate belt buckle. And it's of like a oil field type thing. This one is a Superman belt buckle. And this one, it looks like it has some like scratches in the resin, but I think that's still cute. This one doesn't say where it's from, but it's very shiny and there's a price on it that says $50, so probably from some store before Goodwill. But that is the buckle. Looks like there's some like cattle ranchers on it. There is an eagle belt buckle. That's pretty cool. This one looks a bit it looks a little tarnished. This one is a bass belt buckle, and the date on it is 1978. So this one's really old. Indiana Metalcraft. That's where it's from. This one is like a Texas Longhorn belt buckle. There's no engraving on the back saying what it's made of or where it's from. This one is a Texas belt buckle. This one's pretty big. This one is the Texas Sterling Collection 1989, and it is solid brass. This one is from the Texas Sterling Collection, and it looks like it's 1981, I think. But that's what it looks like. I don't know if I'm holding it upside down or not. I'm not sure what the engraving is of. And then this one is the State of Texas belt buckle. And it's also the Texas Sterling Collection 1981 solid brass also. And that is it for those belt buckles. I also got these shoes. These are like really old fashioned women's shoes, but they're made in Italy. They're, Salvatore Ferragamo, like made in Italy women's dress shoes. And I figured I would get them because, I don't know, why not? But the comps were really good for the brand, but I don't know how well these ones will go since they're older. They might be in my size though, so if I'm wanting to keep them for like wearing old-fashioned things, there we go. But yes, these are Salvatore Ferragamo made in Italy heels. There's the stuff on the bottom, and they look like they're in decent condition for like how old they are. The like actual heels are a little messed up, but we'll see what I do with them. And I also have another belt buckle. This one is a train belt buckle. It is 1978 Baron buckles, and it is solid brass. And then I believe this is the last belt buckle. I have a lot of belt buckles. This one is a Bass 1990 belt buckle. And it is made exclusively for the Bass Anglers Sportsman Society, 1990. Cool. I also have this wrap skirt, which is super great for summer. It is Tommy Bahama, 100% silk, size small, but it's one of those like tie wrap skirts, and it's super cute. So there is that. This is a Lululemon tank top, and it has like a tie thing at the bottom. There is the Lululemon symbol thing. And yeah, this one's really cute. It is a size 2. I found the size dot. Hallelujah. So that is a cute black tank top for working out. And then the last bit of the haul is a bunch of belts, which was kind of the same deal as the belt buckle pack. It was just a bundle of stuff thrown together in a bag. So let's go through it. So the first thing that I have is a super thick belt. It's like super nice quality. And there's like this little detailing type thing going on. It is a genuine leather Ralph Lauren belt. And let me see if I can find a size. I don't see a size on it, but I might find it later if I inspect more. But there is the Ralph Lauren logo. Oh, this one's super long. I think this is one of those like wraparound belts, so you have to like wrap it twice. But this one's also a Ralph Lauren belt. And I believe this one also was 100% genuine leather. I'm not sure. I think it was. Whenever I post it, I'll be sure to include all the details and stuff. I can't find it now. But yes, this is... Oh, the belt buckle's solid brass. Yeah, I can't find the leather information. But I'll be sure to include that if I can figure it out. But yes, super long belt. And then this belt is also Ralph Lauren with a super crazy belt buckle. And it's very like shiny and stuff. This is a size medium belt made in Italy. And it's genuine lizard. So, which is interesting. But yeah, I thought that this one was kind of quirky. But this belt was one of the reasons why I bought it, because I saw the Made in Italy on it and I was like, ooh, this might be something good to get. So I bought it. And then there's also this belt, which is also Ralph Lauren. And this one is like hairy. Made in Italy and it is genuine zebra. I know when I told my, cause I already went through this belt or these belts and stuff. My mom was kind of like, oh, that's like sad and stuff, which it is. Oh, this is a size large, by the way. And she was like, I don't know if you should sell that. And yeah, I'm kind of, I might stick it up in my shop and then I might take it down if it doesn't get any traffic or anything, just because I did spend the money on it. But yeah, that kind of sucks. But, I don't know. Okay. And then we have this other belt, which has this cool additional buckle detailing type stuff going on. It is another Ralph Lauren belt, and it is genuine leather. So that is really cool. I wonder if that's brass also. I don't know, it doesn't say. It is a size large. We have another belt. It never ends. This one, I think the only detail on this is this bar thing. It's another Ralph Lauren belt. It's made in England. Size 38. And it does not say whether it's genuine leather or not. But that is the belt. And then the last belt I have is not Ralph Lauren. This one is Jasper and Jahira, and it's all beaded. And it's really nice. It's genuine leather made in India, size large. So all the inside is leather, and it's very like bendy, like soft leather. But yes, all of this is beaded. And I think this belt is so cool. I think this one's my favorite. That is like gorgeous. And yeah, I have not looked up comps on this, so I need to look up comps. I'm really excited to find out like what the comps are for it, because it's so pretty. Like, I love this belt. I kind of want to keep it for myself, but I'm probably going to sell it because I don't think I'm a size large in belts. So, yeah. Okay, so that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like and comment if you have ever had a lot of success on buying stuff from the Goodwill online auction website. And let me know if you guys think I had a good haul. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like food videos, haul videos, story time videos, thrifting videos, more videos like that, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!